Well, this is one of those pucker your butt moments. That didn't sound right. Why did that sound like that?
This video is brought to you by Sporlan. Quality, integrity, and tradition.
We're out on a walk-in freezer today, and the complaint was actually that the unit was not working yesterday. And we called them, and they said there was no power, nothing was running, so we had them go check the breaker. And the manager said the breaker was tripped. So she reset it, and she said that it kept tripping, and it kept tripping. Well, come to find out, she didn't understand how a breaker trips, and she never reset it. So she physically had to shut the breaker off, then turn it back on. Once she did that, it ran, and it's been running since. But I came today to do a follow-up to see what's going on. So I come in here, temps are a little bit high. Temps are a little bit high in here, and I noticed that the coil has a pretty heavy frost on it. And this fan motor is vibrating really bad. So we're gonna go out and look at the condenser unit first. We might have a fan motor that's vibrating, causing a wire to rub or something. We're gonna go out and look at the condenser unit and see what that tells us. So my condenser's looking clean. Don't see any problems there. Don't see any issues here. And I did get some clarification. It was today, this morning, that she reset the breaker. So that makes sense why the temps are probably still a little warm. It's been running ever since. All right, well, we're just gonna be trying to figure out why the breaker tripped. So I'm gonna investigate the electrical panel, maybe throw it in a defrost, and then possibly go check the coil to see if that vibrating is causing an issue or something. So, all right, I don't see anything jumping out at me in the compressor section. It's a 404A system. Everything looks good, but I mean, you know, we'll investigate more. It is currently 12 o'clock in the afternoon, and the time clock is definitely off by about, well, it says 13. So I don't, that time clock's off. There's no way. It's been off for a while, so it's off by like 12 hours probably or something. So again, 1226. I mean, it wasn't horrendous. That's weird. Huh. Interesting. Okay. Compressor contactor definitely has some like carbon buildup or something right there. Maybe investigate the inside of that guy. We can do a voltage drop test across it real quick. Nothing. No voltage drop across the contactor, so that doesn't look bad. I don't see any issues. Here, you gotta be careful because, you know, we gotta watch out moving things. We kinda just wanna move the wires around, see if there's an arc. See how they're kinda rubbing right there? That could be a spot. Don't see any issues. Being careful not getting my face too much into this. Okay, don't see any issues there. I'm gonna pull this cover off and just inspect the inside of that contactor real quick. I just powered the unit down. This contactor looks really bad. And they're black inside. Oh yeah, really bad. That's definitely not good. And it's probably hard for you guys to see that, but it's, that shadow is not a shadow. It's all black in that contactor. So just because it doesn't have a voltage drop, that doesn't look good. That thing's been arcing for sure, making bad connection. We are gonna change that contactor for sure. Whether or not that's the only problem, I don't know. We're going to, what would cause that though? Because, you know, on some of these Heatcraft units, they can short cycle, but this one, because it doesn't have the electronic expansion valve or the QRC board or the intelligent board, this one still has a time delay. So it's not short cycling. The time delay basically locks it out and only lets it come on every couple minutes or something like that. I can't remember the lockout time. I'm just testing to see if we have loose wires. Everything's off. I mean, it's not the tightest in the world, but it's not loose enough to cause arcing. These top ones are definitely really tight. The bottoms were a little bit loose, but I don't think those are the issue.
Wow, man, that was really, really firm.
Okay, well, we got the power off. We're gonna go ahead and go inside and look at that vibration in the evaporator fan blade.
So there's quite a bit of ice, and there's no way that's just from this morning. I'm kind of questioning. I'm gonna go ask them what breaker they were resetting. This is interesting, because for a unit, yeah, that doesn't make sense, that much ice. I'm not seeing anything scary that's jumping out at me yet. I mean, I'm gonna still look at everything, but I don't see anywhere where the wire's rubbed out yet. Nothing scary. I mean, is that possibly? Nope, it didn't rub through. This is a new coil, so. And then over here, I mean, that's a rat's nest, but. At this point, I'm gonna go ahead and throw it into defrost. Watch the unit defrost and see what happens.
I'm getting ready, so I'm trying to figure this out. The door doesn't shut right, so that could be why it's iced up, but I still don't understand why the breaker was tripped. It doesn't make sense to me. The unit is nowhere near just coming out of a defrost. So it looks like it would have defrost. Well, but again, I don't know how long it'd been off for, so these times may not be right, but it does 3 defrosts a day. Okay. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tone everything out to ground, see if we have any direct shorts in the defrost circuit. I guess I should be able to do it right here, actually, I think. Let me test to see if that's a good ground. And, hold on, I'm gonna turn the camera off for a sec. So I turned the camera off for a second, I toned out this screw to ground and it's good. So we've got nothing to ground on this time clock. Nothing, nothing. So we're not grounding out. So at this point, I'm gonna fire it up and put it into defrost and see what happens when I put it into defrost. Go test the heaters and everything. All right, here we go. It's running. Let's go ahead and crank this guy into defrost. Okay. Red light came on, should be pumping down, and we should have current draw on this blue wire right here, which is number 3. 9 amps, that seems pretty accurate for the defrost circuit, so we're gonna go inside and test all the heaters. We'll leave it running, put it in a really long defrost, that way it doesn't, well, it can still time out on the X terminal or temp out on the X terminal, but we'll let it run to test that too.
I really don't see anything jumping out at me in here. Everything looks okay. This is a drain line heater. That's because these things pull very minimal amps on these drain line heaters, so they're always a pain. It's not a drain pan, it's that cut to fit drain line heater. Feels like it's kind of warm. Can also hit it with a thermal imaging camera to tell you if it's working. I'm just gonna amp out every one of these heaters, see if they all amp out. It's gonna be hard to get them all right now. So let's see. That one's running. That one's running. That's the same heater dummy. All right. Sometimes I impress myself too. Okay. The inrush button. So that heater's working. What about that heater? That heater's working. There we go. 3 amps. And then there's one more heater on the top. I'm gonna have to put the camera down to get to that top heater. But everything is working. This is really bizarre. I don't see any direct shorts. I don't see any burn marks. The only thing I saw was that compressor contactor outside. I don't like this. This is interesting. Don't see any issues with the motor. That vibration, I'm still concerned about that, whatever that vibration was. We'll have to look at that blade when we put it all back together. It's possible ice has been falling on it or something.
Man, my call earlier today, I don't know when I'm gonna make the video about it, so you guys don't know about it, but my call earlier today, there was a big beehive on the roof making they had a giant hive in the parapet wall structure. And I look up right now, we got bees right here. They're in the wall making a hive. Now I will say that these ones are not as aggressive as the ones earlier today. It was bigger and they were swarming. Like, they weren't attacking me, but they were letting me know that they were there, basically. You know, coming out at me and pushing me away from their hive. These ones are being super chill. They're not bothering me, but it's interesting. All right, well, I just did a visual inspection in the condensing unit. I don't see anything wrong. I don't see any rub outs on the wires, nothing there. I'm gonna let this thing keep running and defrost, and then I'll probably have to get my hose out. But I don't see any reason for this breaker to trip yet besides that contactor. I had to go to the supply house to get the right contactor because I didn't have the one with lugs and I didn't want to have to convert everything. So I got a new one right here. While I was doing that, I let it run in the long defrost and I just went and checked on it. It's almost completely thawed out, so I probably won't even have to get my hoses out. So we're gonna get this guy swapped out. I already turned off power. I'll verify real quick and then we'll swap out that contactor. Man, I lost a wire. This one back here. I lost a wire when I was starting it up, or when I was hooking it back up, meaning that I lost track of where it went. But following the schematic, it should be going to that side of the contactor coil. So, oh, this is one of those pucker your butt moments. That didn't sound right. Why did that sound like that? What was that about? That sounded horrendous. Really bad. What the fudge was that about? That was the compressor. That wasn't anything I did wrong. What the heck? We gotta trace that out. That did not sound good at all. That's really strange. Everything seems correct. I checked voltage at the disconnect. I got 3-phase power. I'm wondering if this is what caused the breaker to trip. We're not in defrost. Interesting, man. That thing sounded horrendous. What the heck is going on here? Everything checks out okay. So I don't think I did anything wrong. Oh, man. Sketch. I'm gonna have to turn this thing on again. Test to see what the heck is going on here. It's got an amp clamp on there. I better put this electrical cover back on because we don't know what's gonna happen here. Okay.
Locked rotor is 88.
See if this thing makes this god-awful sound again. Compressor sounds like dirt. Sounds like it's running backwards, right? But I hooked it up. The same. Black, red, blue. I'm really dumbfounded right now. What is going on here? All right, I disconnected the compressor contactor. I want to turn this on and see what happens. Okay, compressor contactor is disconnected. I want to check phase rotation now. See if something funky is going on in here. That's really bizarre. It says it's backwards. But I wrote it down as black, red, blue. You know what the possibility is that maybe it was switched on the bottom. And I put it back as 1, 2, 3, possibly. Huh, this is interesting. Still blown away, but all right, we're gonna turn it on and see what happens. That's really weird because I don't remember switching those things around. So I'm almost positive. I'll have to go back and review the camera footage too. Maybe you guys could have already done it. Because I wrote it down as black, red, blue on the top, the main power coming in. But it's possible that I saw the wire numbers on the bottom because they're labeled from the factory. And it's possible that when we installed this unit, we made the phase rotation switch right there. Huh, that's really bizarre. All right, so that's much better. Okay, we need to go put the inside unit back together and then finish checking everything out.
Look at that, I pulled the contactor apart. Look at how bad that is. This thing's less than a year old. Look at how burnt it is in there. That's crazy.
Okay, well, I didn't find anything else wrong inside. Compressor's amping correctly. Condensed unit's amping correctly. The only thing I want to do to go check is go look at the breaker and see what the what size breaker it is. These are 30 amp fuses out here, so I'm curious why a fuse didn't blow. We'll see. We'll get in there. I should go check on the evaporative fan motors here in a minute. I'm just going to put this all back together. Let's see if the sight glass is still clear. Sight glass is clear. So we're going to put it together and then we'll go check the breaker size and the evaporative fan motors and make sure they're running good. Yeah, I guess, I mean, I don't know why this isn't making me comfortable. Like, yeah, that's not good. But I don't know, just for something to trip a breaker, I'm looking for something bigger than that for some reason. But the fact that it's black, that's not good. You know, it might have been not making good contact and single phase in the compressor or something. All of a sudden, this unit's satisfied and I'm freaking out wondering what's going on. Check it out. They were actually doing their job. When they opened the door, someone twisted the twist timer. This thing's still got a vibration to it though. We're gonna have to put a new blade on this one. I don't have it with me, but we'll send someone back out here. And that'll give me an opportunity to let it run through the day too, so that way we can follow up on it. So I'll get a blade and I'll have someone else change that out. Yeah, that is bizarre because this is a 40 amp breaker. 13, 15, 17 is the walk-in freezer. It's not getting hot. I don't understand why it was tripped and not blowing the fuses. Well, time will tell. Like I said, we're gonna come back and change that fan blade and then we'll follow up on it then.
Did you guys see what I did wrong? It's funny what the power of video footage does to you. I don't know if I was completely colorblind or what, but I totally got the incoming power colors wrong. Okay, I think I said the original, I have it written down right here. It was black, blue, red, and I had it switched up. I wrote it down on the cardboard box wrong. Life happens, guys. People screw up. As long as you know how to get out of your problems. I make mistakes every single day, just like you guys do. Okay, everybody makes mistakes. Life happens. Luckily, there was no major repercussions. I heard the noise. I shut off the compressor immediately, got it going. Okay, so since this video was shot a couple months back. It's been sitting in my footage. I've had the breaker trip again, okay? Gone through the entire system. Again, everything checked out. Okay, this time the contactor wasn't burnt, but, the next time the contactor wasn't burnt. But what I have actually concluded the problem is that twist timer. That twist timer, what it does is it's a load timer, basically. So when they get a product delivery or whenever they're going to be in the walk-in freezer for an extended period of time, we installed that so that way when they twist on it, it disconnects the neutral wire or the common wire to the evaporator coil and thus makes the system pump down, okay? When that happens, I should say the customer uses that often. We install these a lot on their restaurants. It's just a common thing. But since then, like I said, I've had the breaker trip again, and I went out there and I found that entire twist timer assembly was completely full of ice and saturated and wet in there. And it's been just filling up with water and moisture and everything from the infiltration from the conduit and all that stuff. It's just a pain in the butt. So I had since, again, on the second time that I went out, I disconnected that twist timer and it has now been months and we haven't had a problem. Now, on another note, I mentioned that the door wasn't shutting right, okay? That's actually something that we're in the process of replacing that whole entire door. So we're gonna go back in with a new bolt-on door. And then when we do that, we'll actually replace that twist timer assembly and design the way the electrical goes to it so that way we don't have the potential for moisture intrusion or the ice to get inside there. We'll make sure that we fill the conduit with silicone on each end so that way it prevents stuff from making it all the way back into that. But what happens on these old boxes, the walls get saturated with moisture and different things like that, and it just slowly builds up.
The door itself, I didn't get any footage of it, but the door is just, it's all twisted and bent. It's already an existing bolt-on door, but they've just, it's just destroyed. This happens at these old restaurants. So that, or we never had, ever since I disconnected that twist timer, we haven't had another issue with it. Yeah, and that's pretty much it. Now, I still don't know why that contactor was burnt up, though. That was a trip. But again, we haven't had the contactor problem yet either, so... Hey, like I said, again, everybody makes mistakes. Just know how to resolve them and fix them and catch them before it becomes a big issue, okay? Running that compressor backwards for an extended period of time can certainly cause damage. Running it backwards for a short period of time, you know, it's not the greatest thing, but it is what it is, you know, it happens. So I really, really appreciate you guys making it to the end of this video. Please, please consider subscribing to my channel if you haven't already. Leave me some feedback. Leave me a comment. Give me a thumbs up, a thumbs down. If you're interested, there's a couple different methods that you guys can support the channel. Okay, the easiest way to support the channel is simply watch the videos all the way through and leave me feedback and leave me a comment. That's the easiest way, okay? There's also monetary ways that you can support the channel. Monetarily, I was tripping over that word, if you would like to, okay? You can go to my website, hvacrvideos.com. I have merch available. I have hats, I have beanies, I have shirts, and stay tuned this upcoming week. We should be launching our new merch too. I will make an announcement on a video when that happens, but I would say that within a week or so, we should have beanies, hats, a new shirt design, the old shirt design, and hoodies available. So let's hope we get that all dialed in and stuff. So please, please, if you guys are interested, check out the website, hvacrvideos.com. There's other ways too. If you guys are interested, if you're considering purchasing any tools, you can check out truetechtools.com. And if you find anything you like, if you like their pricing, you can use my offer code BIGPICTURE, one word, and you'll save 8% on your order. If you guys know what you want to get, you can shoot me over an email and I can generate an affiliate link that helps me out a little bit more. You can also become a Patreon supporter or a patron. There's links in the show notes of this video. You can also become a YouTube channel member. Yeah, and that's it. So again, I really, really appreciate you guys. Remember, I do live streams Monday evenings, 5 p.m. Pacific on YouTube, work permitting. And I also go live on the HVACR Overtime YouTube channel, or HVAC Overtime. Yeah, HVAC Overtime YouTube channel with my buddies. Bill, Curious HVAC Guy, Adam, A-Team Adam, Joe, HVACR North, and myself. And we usually just hang out, talk about the week, you know, recap everything. So definitely check out that too. There'll be a link in the show notes of this video to the HVAC Overtime channel and all that good stuff. All right. Really, really appreciate you. And we will catch you guys on the next one.